In the case against Casey Anthony are working their way through 110 prospective jurors in Pinellas County. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sagowski. Casey has been sitting behind bars for years, awaiting her day in court. Now that it's come, the enormity of the case seems to be getting to Casey.
Now, she looked both nervous and scared as she sat in court. Each juror answered questions about whether they can give up 2 months of their lives to help decide her fate.
We do have team coverage as the trial gets underway. WESH 2's Aixa Diaz has more on why the jury is coming from the Clearwater area.
Kara Moore is talking with WESH 2 legal analyst Judge O.H. Eaton about why the defense is unhappy with the jury pool.
But first, let's get out to Bob Keeling live at that Pinellas County courtroom. And Bob, a rather emotional day for Casey.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You know, outside here, it's been very orderly. We haven't had any protesters. We have had extra security inside, but things have gone very smoothly. Yes, there have been tears from Casey Anthony today. Also, an unsuccessful challenge from her defense team to strike the entire jury pool. 936 days after her indictment for murder, jury selection for Casey Anthony's murder trial is underway in Clearwater. Court administrators made the location official just after 6 a.m. 110 members of the Pinellas County jury pool filed into the courthouse.
In calling you here today for jury duty, we are mindful of the enormous inconvenience we will be imposing.
The 12 jurors and 8 alternates chosen will be taken to Orlando and sequestered for 6 to 8 weeks. They're not to watch news, read the papers, or surf the net.
Including tweeting, texting, blogging, email.
The defense moved quickly to strike this jury pool for lack of minorities.
It should be representative of the population of Orange County, and which I don't think that this panel does.
Your request to strike the panel will be denied.
Anthony sat facing the jury pool, dabbing tears, avoiding all the eyes gazing upon her. You could hear a pin drop as Perry read the murder indictment.
Count 1, first-degree murder.
Perry told the jury pool not to consider shows of emotion. Lighter moments of day 1 included a short power outage.
And a number of alternates, I guess without lights.
And the first question asked to potential jurors known by number only, would serving be too much of a hardship?
And what about your wife?
She might be happy to get rid of me.
Now, so far they've been running about 2/3 of the jurors have been dismissed because they say this is just too much of a hardship to serve for this long. One other important note coming out today, a ruling from Judge Perry on those positive sniff tests on the air in Casey Anthony's car that showed positive for decomposition. He ruled today that the prosecution will be able to use that evidence in her trial. That makes it a scientific clean sweep for the state. We'll have much more from here at 5 o'clock. Reporting live in Pinellas County, I'm Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.
Now that we know where the jurors will come from, the question turns to why. Why did Judge Perry choose Pinellas County?
WESH 2's Aixa Diaz continues our team coverage.
It takes about 2 hours to get to Pinellas County from Orange. Take I-4 all the way down and you're almost there.
Its proximity to Orlando may be one reason Judge Belvin Perry chose Pinellas County for jury selection in the case against Casey Anthony. But even though it's close, Pinellas County isn't a different television news market. Viewers there have likely not seen much media coverage of the case. We spoke to veteran attorney Jeff Dean, who says the judge may also have chosen Pinellas because it's a cosmopolitan area. St. Petersburg and Clearwater are its two biggest cities. Dean also says Pinellas County residents are used to high-profile big city crime stories, unlike residents in more rural parts of Florida. The actual trial will take place in Orlando. It's expected to last for weeks, if not months, so jurors will have to leave their jobs and families behind. Dean says because Pinellas County has a large retirement community, people there are more likely to have the time and availability to be sequestered.
Dean also says demographics, things like age, gender, and race, don't really play a role in choosing a county for jury selection anymore. Now that potential jurors are chosen from a list of driver's licenses, that makes a jury pool more diverse. Aixa Diaz, WESH 2 News.
Casey's defense says the jury pool is not diverse enough.
Yeah, Team Casey is asking the judge to strike the Pinellas jury pool and start over.
WESH 2's Kara Moore continues our live team coverage. And Kara, you spoke with our legal expert about why the defense says Pinellas isn't good for Team Casey.
Yeah, Judge O.H. Eaton says it's not Pinellas County the defense has a problem with. It's the lack of minorities, specifically African Americans, in the jury pool. And that's no surprise, he says. According to Judge Eaton, it is not unusual for the defense to want African Americans to be on the jury. They are less likely to vote for the death penalty. But he said, generally speaking, it is difficult finding African Americans who are willing to serve on capital cases.
The African-American experience in the United States with capital punishment is much different from white Americans. And so naturally, the defense would like to have people on the jury who are skeptical about the death penalty.
And one item that both sides are dealing with is the idea of hardships and how tough it will be to find jurors who want and are able to be away from their jobs and their families for so long. Our legal expert weighs in on that coming up at 5 o'clock. Back to you.
Kara, thanks. It's been nearly 3 years since we first learned of Kaylee Anthony's disappearance. Kaylee was last seen on June 16, 2008. She wasn't reported missing until the following month. Casey was initially arrested July 16. Her daughter's remains were discovered that December.
We saw a much different looking Casey today. Take a look at the difference in mugshots. One taken today in Pinellas, the other from her initial arrest. You remember seeing her walk rather confidently into the Orange County Jail wearing that blue 82 hoodie right there. And today, a tired looking and at times emotional Casey looking around the courtroom nervously, even rubbing her wrists as if she was wearing handcuffs. And you can count on WESH 2 for continuing coverage of Casey Anthony's trial. We will be staying in Pinellas County to bring you late breaking developments in the jury selection. You can watch the entire trial streaming live on our website at WESH.com.